Good evening, everyone. It's Healthy Habits Wednesday, and so many people are out there traveling this month. I mean, even our friends. We've had six people we know that took Alaskan cruise in the last month, so everybody's out and everybody's traveling. So here's some tips to help you stay healthy and safe during your trip. Travel has many benefits for our health and wellness because it helps us to leave our stress, work, and daily grind behind. It also gives us a chance to slow down, absorb new experiences, focus on making meaningful memories. Blocking time out on your calendar to travel also promotes brain health and challenges your perceptions. So when you experience a new environment, you heighten your observations and your focus intensifies, and this sharpens your mind. So by stepping into a new place, you can gain perspective on your life and you can greatly reduce the feeling of burnout or exhaustion at work or in your everyday life. Because travel is so good for you and has many benefits, it's important to also ensure that you don't get sick while you're traveling and that you travel with safety tips in mind. Okay? Because you don't want to get sick, you don't want to ruin your time away. You've planned for it, you've waited for it, and it's here. So what's really important when you travel is hydrate, hydrate, hydrate. The day before you begin traveling, make a concerted effort to remain totally hydrated. This can be difficult when you're boarding planes, trains, or automobiles, but the rewards of remaining healthy is worth it. So equip your body to handle stress, and drink lots of water both during transit and the duration of your trip. If you're heading to a place where water is unsafe to drink, consider bringing a water treatment kit or a water treatment bottle with you. I've seen those on the internet. I am guilty of this when I travel. You know, I'm always, a lot of times I drive somewhere, so I will hesitate to drink a lot of water because I don't want to have to stop at the bathroom so much. But it's super important that we don't do this, and it's a good reminder to myself for my next trip. Also, you want to pack snacks. I mean, none of us have ever sat in the airport for an extra couple hours or on an airplane, okay? Because if you pack your snacks, you're going to reduce eating junk food, but you're also going to reduce the risk of exposing yourself to bacteria. And this is especially helpful if you have a sensitive stomach or some food allergies. While it's great to sample the local fare of where you're coming, it's also handy to have a little food on hand just in case you can't locate a suitable place to eat. And this will always help you not be tempted by local junk food or sugary, greasy snacks, which do nothing to keep you healthy or boost your immunity. I know for me, I pack everything. People that have traveled with me make fun of me. My go-to is I always bring apples. I always bring protein powder. I always bring a bottle for water, and a lot of times I'll pack a peanut butter and jelly sandwich on whole grain bread because those last a while and they fill me up. Also, take sleep seriously during your travel. If you've got a long flight or a long car ride, do whatever it takes so your body can get some rest. Bring an eye mask, earplugs, soothing music. Try to go to bed at a reasonable hour the night before you're going to leave, and work with your body to adjust to time changes. Because if you get a solid 8 hours, you'll feel refreshed and energized to explore each day. You also want to sit down while traveling on public transit. Find the least crowded spot on your train, plane, bus, or boat, if it's possible, and try to sit down. Your chances of touching a pole or a handle swarming with germs will be lowered because you're not hanging on to anything. So I hope you take those health tips seriously. Again, it's stay hydrated, pack some healthy snacks, take your sleep seriously. I know a lot of times when you land somewhere, you just want to run around and go look at everything right away. But, you know, if it's nighttime and it's within your normal schedule, go to sleep. And then bring carry-on items with you as well, like hand sanitizer, baby wipes, maybe a small first aid kit. I know when I went overseas, I did a lot of reading on blogs before I went, and I brought lots of little packs of Kleenex because there was always an issue with paper for the bathroom. And I made sure that I'd decongestant, stuff if I, you know, went to the bathroom too much, stuff if I didn't go to the bathroom too much, and lots of other things, you know, wipes and gels for my hand and everything, because I didn't know where I was going and what my access would be. You also want to focus on safety tips when you travel, so do your research before you go, which is what I did, okay? Look at blogs, look at people that have been to the area before and see what they have to say. Try not to look like you're from out of town. So this was really helpful too when I traveled overseas. I looked at what type of dress they wore, what was appropriate for a woman my age, because a lot of other countries and areas don't dress maybe as casual as we do in the States. Also, you want to make some copies of your important documents, maybe before you travel, in case something happens to you. Hopefully it won't, but in case it does, your family's prepared. Keep your friends and family updated throughout your trip. Send them a text. You know, have a communication schedule in case something does happen to you on your trip. Make sure they're aware of your plans, aware of your itinerary as you're going. You know, be very wary of public Wi-Fi when you travel and you access the internet to make sure it's secure so you don't have any issues with fraud. And you may want to safeguard your hotel room. I know when I worked for Bristol-Myers and I traveled, I kind of had this little gadget that went on the door handle so nobody could push the door into the hotel room. Call me paranoid, but, you know, it was a safety issue when you travel alone as a woman to a big city. And always be aware of your surroundings. Don't let your guard down. To snap the perfect picture for social media or to post along your way. Be aware where you're at, so you know you're cautious. So I hope that helps you as you travel this summer, because you are going to be doing a lot of traveling. Everybody's traveling. We've all been cooped up for a couple years, and we're out and we're about and we're traveling. So stay hydrated, get your sleep, pay attention to what you eat. Sit down instead of hanging on to all these germy things like handrails and everything, and practice safety tips. So thanks, and we'll see you in a couple weeks. Have a good one.